throughout the world. Macabre orgies, weird exotic rites, depraved sex ceremonies. You will see for the first time, they're all revealed in this daringly authenticated film. Come with me now to a black mass.
We invoke the queen of queens.
Thank you.
function as well in artificial conditions as in a living organism. And for this purpose, blood is introduced into the cardiac vessel. The isolated heart beats just as it did a few hours previously in the living donor. The revival of individual organs enables scientists to see to experiment on reviving the whole organism. The revival of the whole organism can be achieved with the help of an apparatus called the autoejection. The following experiment is conducted on lungs taken from an organ. The autoejector carries out the function of the lungs and fills them with air. Rhythmical contraction supplies the body with arterial blood rich in oxygen. The venous blood is forced into the lungs by the action of the pump. The dark venous blood passes through this tube and returns to the heart through the vein. From there, the lungs, it turns into the lungs and becomes arterial. Once with a fresh supply of oxygen, it returns to the heart. Then spells into the arteries of the lungs. Isolated lungs breathe, producing the same chemical changes as in the living animal. The autoejector works on the same principle. The apparatus includes a system of cups to supply the blood by drawing it out. The arterial pump supplies the organism with arterial matter. When the blood is given up its oxygen, the venous pump draws the blood into the rectum. Here, just as in the lungs, it's enriched with oxygen and returns into the organ. The blood passing into the arteries of the body ensures the necessary metabolism. The autoejector can perform the work of both the heart and lungs.
Thank you.